this woman to be wedded to this man?
Her mother and I do.
Proceed. Come up here if you can. If it's too close, let me know. You may all be seated. We would like to start by welcoming everyone here. Thank you for being here on this most happy of days. I have the great fortune to know many of you here, but for those of you who I haven't met, my name is Marty DeFrisco, and I am Grace's uncle. And I'm about to be Jose's favorite uncle. Why is that funny? Grace and Jose don't have big hard luck stories. They both grew up with strong and loving parents and had pretty happy lives all on their own. Even so, once their love was established, they realized how much more fulfilling life could be with each other in it. As they stand before us today, we can see the happiness on their faces. And they are smiling because only now do they have everything they will ever need. They have each other, and they are each other's family. Grace and Jose, what you've accomplished is no small feat. Your journey began way before you sent out and resent out the invitations, before you chose this lovely venue, or even before you decided to spend the rest of your lives together. The journey began when Jose strategized to ignite a spark while Grace and her friends were simultaneously scheming to grab his attention. A little creepy. One well-placed putt and a specialty slice of pizza later, the fire was lit. You took the time to learn what makes each other smile and how to be there for each other when things are great and when life is not so easy. You welcomed each other's families and friends and joined us together with warmth and enthusiasm. You've created this new village with your love. And we're not even all here. There are so many really special people who couldn't be here in person, but they are right here with us sharing your joy and excitement. From all around the world, your loved ones are joining you because everyone knows you cannot wait to share the rest of your lives together. For the people who cannot be here in person, I'm reminded of this beautiful poem. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. And he puzzled and puzzled until his puzzler was sore. Then he thought of something he couldn't have before. Maybe, he thought, it doesn't come from a store. Maybe, perhaps, it means a little bit more. Grace and Jose, this ceremony and celebration with your friends and family on this extraordinary day is the ribbons, the tags, the boxes, and the bags. But the true meaning of today is you two. Grace and Jose, you are beautiful people. You are kind, generous, talented. And Grace, you're so wonderfully silly and full of life. I know I can speak for the whole family when I say that being a part of your life from the day you were born has been a blessing. Jose, my brief but impactful time with you has made a profound impression. I thank you for bringing joy to Grace and for joining our family, our two families, and your giant circle of friends who have joined together today are all smiling because we know how lucky we are to have you both in our lives. Grace and Jose, this special day is a reminder of what you have already accomplished, bringing us together today and our celebration of all the possibilities of what you will create in the future. I'm going off book. In case you don't know, my niece is named after my mother. Her middle name was Jose. Tie that one around your head. Your love is a source of strength, not only for each other, but also for us, the world around you, and in turn, we, the family and friends surrounding you, have a great responsibility to you. With our care, respect, and love, we can support your marriage and the new family that you are beginning today. The first reading will be presented by Grace's cousin, James DeFrisco.
This is a poem written on July 1st of 1957 by our grandfather, James DeFrisco, 1 month before he married our grandmother, Grace Jose. She was affectionately known as Tiny, and his nickname for her was Tiny Bien, the name of this poem. When day begins at the echo of dawn, who winds me up so that I can go on? Whose voice is like a soothing lotion that urges me from sleep to motion? When day drags by and patience moan, who cheers me up with a buzz on the phone? Who sets my lips aflame with hot fire, with crooked kisses sent by telephone wire? In evening's homebound rush and hot crowds, why am I always far up in the clouds, with pleasant thoughts of the evening gone by and the eternal knot we're about to tie? Then the trek to the office with anticipation, downtown traffic, pails of perspiration, a black-skirted form in a blouse so funny, a slanted smile and a hello, honey. She steps in the car with a speed of Mach 4, then puts her gigantic purse on the floor. She gives me a kiss, the kind I adore, and an hour later she closes the door. We're off, but so are the hands on the clock, and before you know it, the key's in the lock, to the door of the dingy and dreary old place where I will give her my parting embrace. But there's cheer even as I am leaving that den, for I know tomorrow I'll see her again. And soon to bachelorhood I'll say amen and be happy forever with my tiny BN.
Jose, Grace, please face each other. Oh. Jose, do you take Grace Jager Gibson to be your wedded wife, to love her, protect her, provide for her, to be unto her a loving husband, and forsaking all others? Promise unto her your faithfulness.
I do.
Grace, do you take Jose Roberto Cifuentes to be your wedded husband, to love him, inspire, and encourage him, to be unto him a loving wife, and forsaking all others? Promise unto him your faithfulness.
I do.
Well, that was easy.
Eduardo? Okay, there's three, not two. Jose, take this ring and place it upon Grace's finger. As you do, repeat after me these words. With this ring, I give you my heart.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
I promise this day forward, you shall not walk alone.
I promise this day forward, you shall not walk alone.
May my heart be your shelter, and may my arms be your home.
May my heart be your shelter, and may my arms be your home.
Grace, take this ring and place it upon Jose's finger. And as you do, repeat after me these words. With this ring, I give you my heart. With this ring, I give you my heart.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
I promise from this day forward, you shall not walk alone.
I promise from this day forward, you shall not walk alone.
May my heart be your shelter, and my arms be your home.
May my heart be your shelter, and my arms be your home.
The blessing of the coins, or araras, is a symbol of Jose's dedication and responsibility to his wife and their future children. Jose presents the coins to Grace, who accepts the coins to represent her support and commitment to their union.
How do you open it?
Go for it.
Grace, accept these coins as a symbol of all of my possessions, as a pledge to my dedication to our family's well-being. These I offer to you of all that I am and with all that I have.
Jose, I accept them with joy and gratitude, and I offer you these coins in return as a sign of my dedication to our family's well-being. These I offer to you of all that I am and with all that I have.
The second reading will be presented by Grace's cousin, Adam DeFrisco.
Love is a temporary madness. It erupts like volcanoes and then subsides. And when it subsides, you have to make a decision. You have to work out whether your roots have so entwined together that the idea of you ever parting is inconceivable. Because this is what love is. Love is not breathlessness, it's not excitement, it's not the promulgation of promises of eternal passion. That's just being in love, which any fool can do. Love itself is what is left over when being in love has burned away. And this is both an art and a fortunate accident. Those that truly love have roots that grow towards each other underground. And when all the pretty blossoms have fallen from the branches, they find that they are one tree and not two.
Thank you. Jose,
sir.
Repeat after me, won't you?
Yes, sir.
I, Jose Roberto Fuentes, take you, Grace Jaeger Gibson, to be my wife.
I, Jose Roberto Cifuentes, take you, Grace Jaeger Gibson, to be my wife.
To have and to hold her from this day forward.
To have and to hold her from this day forward.
In plenty and want, in joy and in sorrow.
In plenty and want, in joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live.
In sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Grace, your turn. I, Grace Jaeger Gibson, take you, Jose Roberto Cifuentes, to be my husband.
I, Grace Jaeger Gibson, take you, Jose Roberto Cifuentes, to be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
In plenty and want, in joy and sorrow.
In plenty and want, in joy and sorrow.
In sickness and health, as long as we both shall live.
In sickness and health, as long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
You have made your marriage vows to one another, witnessed by your friends and family. Now, by the power vested in me, which is crazy, I get to pronounce you husband and wife. Jose, puedes besar a la esposa. You may now kiss the bride. Face your fans. It's my great honor and privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jose Cifuentes.